Well, it may not feel like it today, but we are in the middle of fall.
If you're looking for a new spin on a fall favorite like squash, our vegan chef, Lauren Montelbano, is here from Vibrant Veg. She's on the weather patio making stuffed acorn squash. Hi, Lauren.
Hi. Hi, Susan. Hi, Mark.
So, oh, this is a great recipe.
Yeah. What are you doing today?
Yeah, now you're making it vegan for us.
Now I'm making it vegan. So I will be stuffing an acorn squash today, although you can also do this with festival squash or any other small squash like this one. It definitely is one of my fall staples. So what I have done here, since I am sans oven here on the patio, I have roasted this ahead of time. And so you cut your squash in half, and then I rub it down with about a teaspoon on each side of olive oil and also maple syrup and a little sprinkling of salt, and then cook it in an oven that's preheated to 400 for about 30 minutes. And then it gets this beautiful golden brown. The maple syrup enhances the sweet. I add in, I've got cooking here, one stalk of celery mixed with half a cup of diced cremini mushrooms and one shallot.
And you're just sauteing that in a little olive oil?
I'm just sauteing that in a little bit of olive oil. I've added some salt and some pepper.
Okay, and then put that aside.
Exactly, we're gonna put this aside. And I have pre-cooked a quarter cup of wild rice. It's also wild rice season, so it's an excellent ingredient to incorporate into your fall meals. We have a quarter cup of cooked brown lentils, just to add a little bit of protein to our meal here. Two tablespoons of toasted pecans for some crunch. Cranberries, quarter cup for a little bit of sweetness and tartness. And then it wouldn't be a fall meal without some fresh herbs. We have thyme that I'm adding. And then I'm just going to mix that all together here. And to flavor that, I'm going to add just a pinch more of salt and pepper. A little bit, actually a teaspoon of maple syrup.
The real stuff.
The real stuff, exactly.
Always use the real stuff.
There's no high fructose corn syrup here. And then also a teaspoon of Dijon mustard for a little sharp bite.
Oh, the maple syrup and Dijon mustard, yes. Sounds like a good combination.
Oh yeah, it's super good. All right, and then we'll see how gracefully I can do this.
Oh, look at how colorful that is.
Beautiful. Exactly, and I mean, you can throw in whatever kind of vegetables you have. I really enjoy the crunch of the celery. It adds a really nice flavor. But I've also done this recipe with carrots and bell pepper, anything else to add a little bit more color. But I always put in the cranberries for that touch of sweet. And the lentils.
Oh, that couldn't be healthier,
yeah,
too.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Now, do you serve this as your main course or as a side dish?
I do serve this as my main course, and actually, typically, if I'm at home, I roast up some Brussels sprouts to serve as a side.
Oh, that looks delicious.
Then
looks
you've
delicious.
Got your absolute fall bounty here with all of the bases covered.
Yeah, the cranberries and the maple syrup. It looks delicious. Well, Lauren, thanks for being here today.
You're so welcome.
We'll have the recipe online for folks.
Yep, channel3000.com. Thanks, Lauren. We'll see you again soon.
Bye.